salient features of phylum Mollusca. Mollusca comprises of the second largest phylum of invertebrates in the number of species. Around 85,000 extant species of mollusks are recognized today. The number of fossil species is estimated between 60,000 and 1 lakh additional species. Possession of a hard shell increases the chances of preservation. This has resulted in a rich fossil record of mollusks. Many mollusks, though, are understudied. Mollusks have the largest marine phylum, comprising of 23% of all the named marine organisms. Many mollusks also live in freshwater and terrestrial habitats. They are highly diverse, not just in size and anatomical structure, but also in behavior and habitat. Evidence exists for the appearance of gastropods, cephalopods, and bivalves in the Cambrian period, 541 to 485.4 million years ago. Mollusks appear to be a heterogeneous group with great diversity of form, but all of them are built on the same fundamental plan. They have developed such a varied range of body structures that finding synamorphies or defining characters to apply to all modern groups is difficult. The most general characters of mollusks are that they are unsegmented and bilaterally symmetrical. The following are the salient features of the phylum. Mollusks are aquatic, mostly marine, with a few freshwater and terrestrial forms. The body is soft, unsegmented and bilaterally symmetrical. It consists of a head, foot, mantle and visceral mass. The body is clothed with a single layer of often ciliated epidermis. The body is commonly protected by an exoskeletal calcareous shell which is secreted by the mantle. The head is distinct. It bears a mouth and has two eyes, tentacles and other sense organs. The ventral body wall is modified into a flat muscular foot. This is modified for swimming, creeping, and burrowing. The mantle is a fold of the body wall which separates the main body mass and the mantle cavity. The visceral mass contains the vital organs of the body in a compact form, taking the form of a dorsal hump or dome. The body cavity is best described as a hemocoel. The digestive tract is quite simple with an anterior mouth and a posterior anus. The pharynx contains a rasping organ called a radula. The circulatory system is open except in a few cases like the bivalves where it is closed. The respiratory system consists of numerous gills or tinea. In terrestrial forms, lungs have developed. The excretory system mainly consists of metanephridia. The nervous system consists of paired ganglia joined by a longitudinal and transverse nerve connectives. Sexes are separates, but some can be hermaphrodites. Fertilization is either internal or external. Direct or indirect development can be observed. Larval forms include a free-swimming trochophore larva. Other larval stages may have a veligial larva or a glaucidium larva.